I tried 5 structural engineering software and the best one was. In today's video, we're delving deep into the world of structural engineering software. I tested 5 of them and ranked each one for functionality, ease of learning, and of course, their price point. Some of them I've been using for quite a long time, while others I just experimented for a couple of hours to get a feel for them. So let's not waste any time and jump right into it. The first one on the list is F2. This software is ideal for students and beginners, and the best part, it's absolutely free. F2 is a 2D structural analysis software with a simple interface and offers basic analysis capabilities, making it a fantastic starting point for students and beginners. However, it's worth noting that its simplicity might leave out some advanced features that professional engineers often require for tackling more complex projects. When it comes to pricing, F2 is a perfect 10 out of 10 because it is free. There is a paid version that costs less than 20 Australian dollars a year, and it offers more functionalities like load case combination. It lands a solid 9 out of 10 for ease of learning and a modest 5 for functionality. Don't get me wrong, it's pretty good. You can even apply Spring's coefficient and do some cool stuff. And for the price, I would give it a 10 for functionality, but because it's only 2D, it doesn't offer standard steel cross sections for different countries, and it doesn't have any design capability for specific codes, I'll give it a 5 compared to the other software that we will discuss in this video. Transitioning to the heavyweight, we have Autodesk Robot, a software that's highly regarded in the industry. This tool comes with a price tag that reflects its robustness. The annual subscription costs 4,815 Australian dollars, and it offers advanced analysis and design capabilities. What I find cool about Robot is that it gives you the option to select beforehand the type of project you will be designing, and it will optimize the user interface for that area of focus. Robot supports many design codes like American, Australian, Eurocode, and many more. It's a fantastic tool for handling complex projects. However, it might be a bit daunting for beginners due to its depth and the array of functionalities it offers. It gets a solid 9 for pricing, mostly because you also have access to other software in the same package, like Revit, AutoCAD, Civil 3D, InfraWorks, Advanced Steel, and much more. The learning curve gets a respectable 8 out of 10. It requires some sweat in the beginning. And in terms of functionality, it scores a solid 9. It would be cool to have as many functionalities for the Australian code as it has for Eurocode and American code. Procon comes next on the list. It is another powerful analysis and design software. It offers several modules, including steel, concrete, masonry, geotechnical, and connection design. They also offer a BIM package and have an integration with Autodesk products such as Revit and Advanced Steel. It supports many design codes like the American, Australian, Eurocode, South African, and others. And the price might vary from country to country, but in Australia, it costs around $8,000 for the annual subscription, which includes steel and concrete design package. It scores a 7 for pricing. For ease of learning, it gets a solid 9. Once you get it, it goes smoothly. And when it comes to functionality, it gets a 9 for the extensive toolbox it offers. Before we keep going with the list, have you ever considered the impact of software piracy on your engineering projects and company data? Not only does it hinder your work efficiency, but it also exposes yourself and company to cyber attacks and the potential theft of sensitive data. In Australia, software piracy is a serious concern that can compromise the security of your intellectual property and put your company at risk. When you use pirated software, you're not only violating copyright laws, but you're also opening the door to potential cyber threats and data breaches. Unlicensed software often lacks essential security updates, making your systems vulnerable to attacks that could compromise sensitive information. Our sponsor for today's video, BSA, the Software Alliance, is at the forefront of the fight against software piracy. BSA is the leading advocate for the global software industry with a commitment to protect its members' software products through monitoring and promoting the legal use of software. In fact, Autodesk and Procon that we have just discussed about are software members of BSA. Archicad from GraphSoft, an architectural software, is also part of BSA. Although most companies in Australia pay for their software licenses, some do not. So it is crucial to report those companies that do not comply, as they endanger everyone's data and contribute to growing number of cybercrime incidents in the country. By using genuine licensed software and reporting the use of unlicensed software with BSA, you're not only ensuring the security of your company's data, but also supporting innovation within the engineering community. I'll leave a link to the BSA report form in the description box below for more information. Remember, investing in legitimate software solutions means you're investing in the longevity of your projects and the protection of your company's reputation. Say no to software piracy and yes to a more secure engineering future. Now let's delve into SpaceGas. This software focused on 3D modeling and analysis has a powerful solver which makes design calculations extremely fast. The Steel Member Design Package supports codes from Australia, America, Eurocode, and Indian code. However, the Concrete Design Package only supports Australian and Indian code. I have used it extensively to design portal frames, steel structures, and connections. The premium yearly subscription costs $4,910 Australian, but like any other software, you can purchase separate packages to suit your needs, which will be cheaper than the premium package. SpaceGas makes its appearance, scoring 8 out of 10 for pricing. It's a strong 9 for ease of learning and a solid 9 for functionality. And finally, let's shine the spotlight on SkySieve. This software stands out for its cloud-based platform, facilitating collaboration from virtually anywhere. The pricing structure is flexible, with the professional packages priced at $129 Australian a month, which works out to be $1,549 a year per user. The software supports codes from US, Australia, Eurocode, Canada, British, and Indian. I played around with it for a couple of hours. Overall, I found it quite user-friendly and I would recommend for engineers of all levels. SkySieve takes stage with a 9 out of 10 for pricing. It's a solid 9 for ease of learning and a 9 for functionality. So to give you my perspective, what I've learned from trying these 5 software is the simpler, the better. The more complex, the easier it is to make mistakes. Understand your specific needs first. If you're just designing simple structures, you might get away with a simpler software or even a free software if you're just testing the waters. If you're designing complex concrete, timber, or steel structure, then you can start sussing out a more powerful software. And the last lesson I've learned when it comes to the design package of those software is that you have to understand what is easier for you. Would you rather spend time modeling this structure, assigning all the restraints, effective lengths, and all the K factors, and inputting all the parameters into the software, and then get the green button? Or are you faster just modeling some simple frames, getting the internal forces, and quickly doing a hand check? If you figure out your style, your project demand, and your project complexity, you can make a better decision when choosing the right software for you. Keep in mind that the ranking for some of this software is just based on a couple of hours playing around with them. So I would suggest you trying them out for yourself to have a better feel for the tools they offer. So what software should I use? That's a question that I get asked a lot and usually come from students and young engineers. My answer is always whichever software you have available. Nowadays, I think These programs are essential to streamline the workflow of an engineer, but in the end of the day, they're only a tool, and the most important part of the design process is your engineering judgment and analytical skills. If you want to know the secret behind iBeam's strength, watch this video next, and I'll see you there.